Welcome to Sunspot. I'm Scott Brooks of the Waxahachie Sun. Appreciate you being here, and appreciate you taking advantage of, hopefully taking advantage of all the things we've done to prepare you for this election cycle. Today, I just want to take a few minutes to share with you maybe a summary of how the experience has gone and what you might expect with the interviews that are being made public today. First, let me just tell you that in Wednesday's Waxahachie Sun, which you can see right here, I wanted you to be aware, if you're not already, that all 11 candidates were asked to fill out questionnaires. That covers both city council and school board. 10 of them did. The one that didn't is Darrin Robinson, who's running for a place on city council again. He has essentially disappeared, so nobody's heard from him or seen him, and he's certainly not campaigning, no signs. I'm not even sure why he put himself on the ballot, but there are extensive answers to in-depth questions in the Sun this past Wednesday, so be sure to get that. We didn't put any word limit on the answers these candidates provided. We printed them just as they were submitted, so it is straight from them that the answers appear. And so there's 20 pages of the Waxahachie Sun that is dedicated to almost all 20, maybe 18 and a half of the pages are election material and content for you. In addition, as you can see by what we're providing today, we interviewed, of the 11 candidates, we interviewed 8 of them here at our Sunspot studio, and just in a kind of a back porch, down to earth, you know, living room kind of way. The idea was to not have any canned answers, not have any prepared statements, not provide questions in advance, not have platitudes and the same old shtick that we might see from other politicians, but to just have a genuine, authentic conversation. I think all of these candidates, certainly know the ones that came in, and I just wanted to give you a sense of how they respond in a setting like that, what their answers were, how they see the issues, and what they want to accomplish for either the school district or the school board. So I enjoyed it, a lot of work. I appreciate each of them coming in. I will make note that, again, Darrin Robinson chose not to show up. Melissa Olson chose not to show up, and Amy Hedtke chose not to show up. Amy Hedtke is running against Dusty Autry for school board. Dusty Autry is the school board president, and I believe that it's fair to say that Amy Hedtke, who spends a lot of time blasting away at the school district and at the administration, and who votes no on almost everything, would be extremely detrimental to the growth of the district. She's, I guess you could say, the antithesis of a Dusty Autry in terms of leadership, integrity, character, style, that sort of thing. So I hope you'll consider that, and you can see her answers to the questions that we asked. You can see those in the Sun. With respect to Melissa Olson, Melissa Olson just won't come in and have a conversation. I think it's fair to assume and to say and to believe, and I don't have anything personal against Melissa Olson. As a matter of fact, I've tried to have a relationship with her insofar as the open door, open communications, even off the record, all that sort of thing, but she won't take advantage of that. When it comes to an interview for city council, as her opponent said, Chris Wright said once, that you ought to take advantage of every opportunity to talk with people so as to get your message out, and I agree with that, but she refuses to come in. So I think the answers to questions like why would you advocate for no new revenue budget in a high-growth, fast-growing, dynamic city like Waxahachie, those answers are very difficult to provide, particularly from somebody in a setting where you're talking to somebody who knows what that would mean. So I'm disappointed that Melissa won't come in and talk. I think you should think about that as you weigh your votes. Melissa did, of all the candidates, Melissa Olson did take up the most space in answering the questions in the Sun, 2,800 words, which is a lot of space. And so I think you can read into that whatever you would like, but that's a lot of information. And so when people talk about being honest and open and transparent but refuse to come in and talk on the record so that voters will be able to see and hear and watch the answers, get information, form an opinion, that sort of thing, I think is a bit hypocritical. So just wanted to share that with you. I do want to also say that Darrin Robinson, if you recall, is the candidate last year who blew up in an interview and stormed out and swore and all, you know, just that sort of thing, and ended up losing in a three-person race last year. He's running against David Hill. I would just encourage all of you to be aware of Darrin Robinson. He was recently terminated by the county for the head. He was the head program director, or whatever you want to call it. I don't know the exact title of the juvenile program in the county, and was terminated after 7 months. So just want you to be aware of those things. But by and large, you'll find that the candidates all came in. Again, they didn't have any idea what the questions were until they got here. And we had, in most cases, at least a 45-minute conversation, some went a little longer. So the point of all this and the work that we do is to provide you with the kind of information that most markets, most voters, most communities don't get. And because of that, we end up with the wild, wild west when it comes to certain school boards and city councils across the country. You've heard a lot about school boards across the country that are having all kinds of conflict, whether it's because of CRT or mask mandates and that sort of thing. So part of the reason is that there's no media outlet there to really provide the reader and voter with enough information. So that's our objective, that's our commitment, that's our obligation. And we take it serious. So my hope is that as a reader of The Sun, a viewer of Sunspot, that you will appreciate all the information you have today and have had this week. So again, in Wednesday's paper, which is the 20th, April the 20th, you will find more information than you've ever found in any print product here in town. And then, of course, all these interviews on Sunspot. Election Day is May the 7th, so when you're watching this, it'll be a little less than, well, right at 2 weeks. So early voting starts next Monday, which is April the 25th, goes through that week. And then the following week, it's May 2nd and 3rd. And then, of course, Election Day is on Saturday, May the 7th. So thank you for watching. We hope that you appreciate what we've tried to do for you and for all voters out there. We really take that job serious. We appreciate your support. I'm Scott Brooks. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you soon. Bye-bye.